From United Nations Television, this is UN in Action.
The Syrian conflict, now in its fourth year, has forced over 2.7 million people to flee the country. The United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights has documented gross human rights violations committed by both sides of the conflict. So far, Syrians have fled to Turkey, Jordan, Iraq, Egypt, and Lebanon. But Lebanon bears the greatest burden, hosting more than 1 million Syrian refugees. Abu Yazan, not his real name, is one of them. He's next in line to see a doctor at Restart Center in northern Lebanon. Abu has been a patient here for nearly 2 years. Before fleeing Syria in 2012, he was accused of being a terrorist and held in detention. He says he was tortured.
بس أكتريتها كان بالأعضاء التناسلية وأبشع شيء كان هذا كله بالحمل إنك تكون غرفة ما بتطلع قد الغرفة هاي نكون فيها 60 64 مرة عدنا 64 شاب.
Dr. Sana Hamza, a psychotherapist, has been overseeing Abu Yazan's treatment.
He came with a lot of precaution and cautiousness. So after built confidentiality with him, he started to have this confidence towards us and also towards himself.
Abu is bitter about the attacks against him and considers them degrading.
أتمنى من الله عز وجل ما يحط إنسان باللي نحطينا فيه وعفوا يعني أنا نحطيت بهيك شيء في غيري نحط بأسوأ من هيك.
Fearing the same fate as Abu experienced, women, men and children continue to cross over into Lebanon in search of a better life where they can live in dignity. And with the help of Restart, which is supported and financed by the UN Fund for Victims of Torture, there's hope, says Director Dr. Suzanne Jabour.
The main services those victims are mental health, included psychiatric services, psychotherapy, and also legal support.
Restart also has treatment centers in the capital, Beirut, and in Tripoli. In 2013, 180 victims were treated. This year, Restart expects to reach at least an additional 150 patients. Although the medical services are provided free of charge, many victims like Yusuf, not his real name, are still reluctant to speak out. When he finally opened up, Yusuf said he was held captive and subjected to electric shock for allegedly taking part in protests.
صار ينزل من دموعي يعني إنه ما عاد شفت أحمر عيونه وقعت بالأرض هون إجوا أخذوني. وقت اللي أخذوني نزلوني على فرع. وقت اللي نزلت لتحت سطحوني على طاولة مثل هاي. صار يقولوا لي بدك تعترف تعترف قل لهم على شو بقى هي الطاولة كلها هي الطاولة كلها كهرباء. صار يحطوا لي كهرباء هون ومن فوق لتحت. صار يشغلوا الكهرباء ويعذبوني.
This kind of information from victims is being documented as evidence on alleged cases of torture, a process that could be useful for future prosecutions, both at a local and international level. Dr. Murad El-Shazli, a psychiatrist and trustee of the UN Fund for Victims of Torture, commended the initiative.
The more fresh your documentation, the more close it is to the actual incident, the more reliable it will become for future purposes. I mean by that, if the case goes to court.
Now, Abu is slowly putting his life back together. With the help of Restart, he found employment at a local school where he teaches calligraphy to special needs children. As for Yusuf, he still has a long way to go before he's at peace. This report was produced by Christine Wamba for the United Nations.